Tonight we start our series looking back at the year in sport. Around the world, the Beijing Olympics will be remembered for the amazing performances from Usain Bolt and Michael Phelps. But New Zealanders had many moments to be proud of in China as well. Michelle Pickles takes a look at the best Kiwi medal haul since Barcelona.
The world watched on the 8th of August 2008, Beijing delivered on its promise to produce the best opening ceremony in modern memory. A week later, on the 16th of August, Kiwi athletes delivered New Zealand's most successful day in Olympic history. It began at the Shunyi rowing course. Mahe Drysdale had been touted as New Zealand's best chance for gold, but the illness which had ravaged his body during the week stole his chance to challenge for Olympic glory. He heroically hung on for bronze.
Drysdale's giving all he can!
You know that I can use somebody.
What a courageous effort by Mahe Drysdale.
Half an hour later, New Zealand had its second medal.
Nathan Twaddle and George Bridgewater, bronze in the men's pair.
It was a bittersweet moment though, likely to be the last time the pair would row together, with Bridgewater heading to Oxford to study. But it was Caroline and Georgina Evers-Swindell who produced the magic moment. Written off by most after failing in their last World Cup regatta, the twins showed they are true champions, fighting back to defend their title in a dramatic photo finish by 1/100th of a second.
New Zealand have won it! It's black to gold! Gold and gold again for Caroline and Georgina Evers-Swindell.
It would be the last time we would see the familiar sight of the twins on the podium. 2 months later, they retired on top of the world.
I hope it's gonna make you notice someone like me.
Meanwhile, at the velodrome, Hayden Ralston was riding to silver in the individual pursuit.
Wonderful moment for New Zealand, Hayden Ralston.
Then, as Super Saturday came to a close, Valerie Vealey lit up the bird's nest. She didn't know it at the time, but with her first throw of 20.56 metres, a personal best, the South Aucklander had won Olympic gold.
She doesn't need to take the last throw, and this is the stuff of a legend.
And Hayden Ralston wasn't done, back on track and riding to bronze with the pursuit team just 2 days after winning silver.
It's a comprehensive victory over Australia and the bronze medal.
Triathlete Bevan Doherty was also back. With 500 to go, it seemed his dreams of gold might become reality, but he just didn't have the legs, and bronze was the best he could do.
And Bevan Doherty, his brave performance, will see him come home in third place.
There were some who thought bronze might be a stride too far for Nick Willis, but his self-belief saw him write another chapter in New Zealand athletics history.
He's got himself in the third place. He's got to stay there. Has he got anything left? One, two, and yes, he gets the bronze medal.
Tom Ashley ended New Zealand's Olympic campaign on a high, Ashley holding his nerve and holding off his competitors to clinch gold.
Tom Ashley, a man of steel, best under pressure in the unforgiving Olympic crucible. Tom Ashley, gold medalist.
Globally, the Games will be remembered for two superstars, Usain Bolt, the lightning-quick Jamaican who did the 100-200 double, and American swimmer Michael Phelps, the first man to win 8 golds at one Games. But as Kiwi athletes bid Beijing farewell, there was plenty to celebrate. 9 medals, 3 of them gold, New Zealand's most successful Olympics in 16 years.
I've been roaming around, always looking down.